Recommendation one of the What Works Clearinghouse Practice Guide, Assisting Students Struggling with Mathematics, Intervention in the Elementary Grades, is to provide systematic instruction during intervention to develop student understanding of mathematical ideas. We use the term systematic to indicate that the intervention's instructional elements build student knowledge over time toward an identified learning outcome in an incremental and intentional way. The What Works Clearinghouse and the expert panel assigned a strong level of evidence to this recommendation. This means that there is consistent evidence that meets What Works Clearinghouse standards and the practice improves outcomes for diverse student populations. Systematically designed interventions usually include a bundle of practices and design features, which are reflected in the practice guide's 5 action steps for carrying out this recommendation. We address this recommendation first because you'll see the use of systematic instruction incorporated in the practice guide's other recommendations. The first action step to carry out this recommendation is to systematically review content with a mix of previously learned and newly learned material within and across lessons. Mixing previous with new problem types helps students remember and discriminate among different problem types. For example, when teaching regrouping with double-digit subtraction, the teacher provides practice on a mix of problems, including problems with and without regrouping, as well as problems that require subtraction or addition. The second action step is to use accessible numbers when introducing new concepts and procedures. With easy numbers, students can focus on the new concept or procedure rather than diverting attention to difficult calculations. As students grasp the concept, the teacher systematically adds harder numbers so that students don't overgeneralize the new concept to the specific numbers that were used to first teach the concept or procedure. The third action step is to sequence instruction in a way that builds student learning incrementally. This requires presenting mathematic concepts in a cohesive and logical way that relates to previously taught concepts. Avoid teaching lessons on isolated topics. Connect concepts day to day and across units to build towards specific learning outcomes. The fourth action step is to provide visual and verbal supports. Verbal supports include teacher prompting or questioning. Visual supports include a gesture or a concrete or semi-concrete representation. And the fifth action is to provide immediate supportive feedback to address misunderstandings. Identify the student's specific misunderstanding by asking probing questions and inspecting their work carefully. Correcting misunderstandings and incorrect procedures early prevents the source of the student's confusion from becoming an enduring problem.